Good morning, guys. Travis Ross with Pacific Safety Solutions. Today I'd like to show you a quick demonstration on how I unravel a capstan hoist. For those of you that have used a capstan hoist, you probably have experienced the whole rope getting bound up onto the drum of the capstan hoist. This is just a quick demonstration on how I solve this little issue that we have with the capstan hoist. Enjoy. Something like this happens. I have 200 pounds on there right now. All right, so you found yourself in that situation. So go ahead and tie it off. So what I'm going to do, the best way to do this is to put a prusik cord on there and then some type of a come along to pull your load down to get it off of this. If you don't have something like that, go to your rope, your load line, find the end of your rope. The end of your rope that's in your bucket probably, maybe about 6 feet of it or so. So what we want to do is transfer the load from the capstan hoist to somewhere else. Somewhere else meaning somewhere else that can actually hold all this weight. So I'm going to just use the trailer hitch. So I'll tie you can tie a bowline. I'm just going to tie a clove hitch with a really long tail. Because I'm going to actually use the tail. Hitch is nice and secure. Right on the hitch mount. Take your rope. It's basically kind of like a taut line hitch. I'll show you a close-up of what it looks like. Alright, so what I want to do is transfer the ropes, the load from this line to this little line here. So I just push it, vector the line out a little bit, and slide it up. Now I got all the weight, mostly on this. I could transfer it. Secure, keep your hands on it, keep it good and tight, and then ease into that little knot. Just let it kind of go in slowly. All right, got enough to fix this. There we go, it's fixed, without any stress. All right guys, first of all, I just want to say that this is not a recommended way to do it. I don't even recommend doing it this way. I recommend getting the proper equipment, getting the proper gear to do this job. The reason why I made this video is because I've gotten many calls in the past, guys out in the field. They get put into the situation and they don't know how to fix it, and they don't have the proper equipment to fix it. So that's why I made this video. This is not a learning video. This isn't a how-to video. It's a way that I figured out how to fix it with just the piece of rope that we have. But again, I don't recommend doing it this way. I recommend doing it the proper way. Get the right gear for the job. All right, guys, that's it. Thanks a lot. Have a good day.